Morning students, we will continue with the MySQL. In last topic we discussed DBMS softwares are used for organizing your databases. And what is databases? It is a collection of interlinked data. So now we will continue with this. We enter password. By default password, no any password is there. For viewing all, displaying all the databases, we have show databases. So here are different databases. And if you want to open any database, for example, here is employee 11. So I will use a command connect employee 11 and semicolon. Now I am connected with the employee 11. If I want to see the different tables inside this, show tables. Here is a one table, EMP1. If I want to know this, I want to display the structure of the table, DESC EMP1. So look at here. Different fields in this tables are EMP ID, name, department, basic, HRA, DA, salary. And their data types are integer, character, character, integer, 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 and integer. Along with there is a size. Here we can, in integer, we can enter 11 digits. And in the case of your character, we can enter 10 digits and here 20 digits. Null means we can keep this field empty. Aap is field ko empty bhi chhod sakte ho. Next is key, whether you have set any primary key or unique key, to yahan pe aap display hoga agar aapne koi aise key set ki hui hai. We will discuss later on how to set these keys. Default value, if user does not enter any data, default value automatically inserted. So yahan pe koi bhi default value nahi hai. And any other extra explanation. So this is the description of a table. Now next is in MySQL the commands are called queries, and there are total three types of queries. Number one, DDL. It is called data definition language. Number two, DML, data manipulation language. Number three, TCL, data control language. So in DDL, we can create, delete, and modify table structure. So यहाँ पे आप table बना सकते हो, table को delete कर सकते हो, table के structure को change कर सकते हो. And remember one thing, in this type of queries, the table keyword is always there. This is always there. For example, create table. Drop table. alter table. Create view, drop view, alter view. We will discuss what is the meaning of view in later on. So all of these are DDL query, data definition language. In this, we create, delete, and modify the structure of the table. We are not linked with the data. Avi, it is clear?
Haan ji, sir.
In second type of queries, these are called data manipulation language. This is linked with insert, display, delete, and modify data in a table. So, किसी भी table में data को delete करना, insert करना, modify करना, in this type of queries we use. Remember one thing here, table keyword is not used. For example, select, insert, delete, update, these queries are used. In DCL, we create, delete, modify users. So it's been users bante hain. Moreover, provides different rights on tables. So whether one user can open the table of another user, there is a read only or read and write only. These types of are different rights are provided on table, and these types of queries are not in our syllabus. So we'll deal with the DDL and DML. Ishmeet, it is clear?
Hanji, sir.
Okay, beta. Now coming to create table. So for creating table, query will be create table, then table name. So remember one thing, table name, you will have to follow some rules like can't start with a number, like space nahi deni, special character nahi use karne, like this. Bracket, field name, then I'm changing the line here for better understanding. Field name, space, data type, and then any condition. Condition bhi keh sakte ho, constraint bhi keh sakte ho, constraints, and then comma. So this is post field one. Okay, so field one, then field two, like this, and so on. And at the end, you will close the braces and then semicolon. Remember one thing here, constraints, conditions are optional. It means we can skip this. Aap isko skip kar sakte ho. Theek hai? So this is the structure of the table. So suppose I want to create a table. So I will use the same structure. Look at here. Table name is suppose student. Field name is roll number. data type is integer. Second field is name. Data type is character. In bracket I take 10. 10 is the size of the field. Then I take marks. It is float. So like this. So same thing I'm going to do in MySQL. So look at here. Create table student bracket start roll number. It is integer. Name, it is character 10, and marks float. Then semicolon. If there is no any error, there will be a message query okay, zero row affected. Avish, any doubt in this?
No, sir.
Okay. Now, if I see the structure of the table, TESC, then student, semicolon. So look at here, roll number, name, marks, integer, character 10, float, like this. So create table is a DDL, data definition language. So this is a come under DDL queries. Now, there are some constraints which we can apply on a table on different fields. For example, in the case of a roll number of a in the case of roll number in your class, these are unique. It means they can't be duplicate. So for this, we have one constraint. Why we use constraint? In order to make it valid entry, in order to receive valid entry from user, we use constraint. There is, we have one constraint that is called primary key. So look at here. I am going to create same type of table, but in row number, I will set primary key. And first of all, look at here how we can set primary key. Simply, primary key can be set on a particular field on a table. Two different methods are there. Look at here, primary. So you will simply write primary key. So your in that field, it means roll number, you have set a primary key. Another method is, look at here, I'm copying this. Don't use your primary key here. At the end, use comma, then primary key in bracket roll. Okay, students, any doubt in this? Sushant? Manviya, Shitej?
Yes, sir.
Concept clear?
Yes, sir.
Ishpaneet?
Anji, sir.
Okay, beta. Now, one question is, I think it should be from your side. Ye dekho humne, there are two methods we applied for primary key. Which method is best? Okay, students, sometime it is possible that we can't set primary key on a particular field, on one field. Otherwise, in a table, we can set primary key. A single primary key we can set, not more than one primary key. पर कई बार क्या होता है कि एक फील्ड के ऊपर प्राइमरी की हम नहीं सेट कर सकते. फॉर एग्जाम्पल लुक एट हियर, आई एम गिविंग वन एग्जाम्पल. Suppose I take here roll number, class name, marks. I take roll number 1, class 10th, name ABC, marks 78. Roll number 2, class 10, name and then marks, then class, roll number 1, class 9, name same, suppose ABC, marks 89. Now roll number 2, class 9, now tell me on which field I can set primary key.
Sir, class M.
Yes, beta.
Sir, class and RN field. Proper sir. Sir, do two primary key lagengi isme.
Beta, dekho. Agar hum iske roll number ke upar primary key laga sakte to hum roll number repeat nahi kar sakte. It is not possible. Moreover, class primary key is not possible. नेम के ऊपर तो आप लगा ही नहीं सकते प्राइमरी की. ठीक है, मार्क्स की भी रिपीट हो सकते, नहीं लगा सकते. इन दैट केस वी विल मेक द प्राइमरी की ऑन द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ टू कीज. दिस इज कॉल्ड कॉम्पोजिट की. इज इट क्लियर क्षितिज? इज इट क्लियर?
यस सर.
तो कॉम्पोजिट की जो होती है बेटा, वी कैन अप्लाई कॉम्पोजिट की बाय यूजिंग सेकेंड मेथड ओनली. फर्स्ट मेथड में प्राइमरी की सिर्फ एक ही फील्ड के ऊपर लग रही है. अगर आपने कंपोजिट की बनानी है, सपोज रोल नंबर एंड नेम, दिस इज कॉल्ड कंपोजिट की एंड दिस इज ओनली पॉसिबल इन सेकंड केस. इट क्लियर?
हाँ जी सर.
ओके, सो नोट डाउन दिस. दिस इज फॉर मेकिंग कंपोजिट की. Simply we can set on a primary key single value पे भी कर सकते हैं, and we can set on a combination of two keys. So this is called, this is primary key. And remember one thing, primary key has two features. One is no duplication of data. So uniqueness, unique data we can enter. Second, no empty field. तो मतलब इसमें आप डाटा एंट्री कंपलसरी है. मतलब आप डाटा एंट्री इज कंपलसरी, तो आपको डाटा एंटर करना ही पड़ेगा. सो दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग. नाउ लुक एट हियर, आई एम गिविंग द डेमो हाउ वी कैन सेट प्राइमरी की. आई एम डिलीटिंग द टेबल. आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीट द टेबल. फॉर डिलीटिंग द टेबल, ड्रॉप table student. So look at here, then I describe table student. So look at here, there is it does not exist. Now next is now create. Okay students, I am going to use the query in multiple lines. So we can use the query in multiple lines. Create table student, enter key, bracket start, roll number, integer, primary key, comma, enter, name, it is character, n, oh I have not used comma there. then marks float bracket close semicolon. So there is a problem now. So prefer to make your queries in single line. Sometime it create problem like this with a. Create table student bracket start roll number integer primary key comma then marks float comma name character then comma marks float bracket close semicolon. So look at here. Now if I describe this table student semicolon, look at here. Key, primary key, null value. No, I can't enter null value because in the primary key it has two features: no duplicate data, and second one is you will have to fill the data. Okay, students. Any doubt in this? Manvia, any doubt in this?
No, sir.
Okay. Next is. There are some more constraints. We are going to discuss this. We have discussed one is primary key. Second constraint is unique. In unique, we can't duplicate the data, but we can keep that field empty. Aap khali chhod sakte field ko. Next is not null. It means we can't keep that field null. Means we data entry is compulsory. Aur agar hum unique or not null ko combine kar dein, toh we will get a primary key. Primary key mein bhi uniqueness hoti hai, and the second is we can't keep that field null. Then there is another constraint, default. If we want to set default value, then next is after default there is check constraint is here. So these are different constraints we can apply on a table. So this is the way. Now next, if you have any doubt, you can raise your hand, Sweta. Primary key we have discussed, and how we can set unique key. So look at here. I'm taking one table here, same table. Suppose I have one field. PAN card. It is a character nature. And I'm using unique. Okay. And if you want to set an make any field as a not null, simply what you will do here, name not null. It means you can't skip the name of a student. Next is check. Beta, check is always defined at the end of your table. Look at here. Check marks less than equal to 100. It means we can't enter the marks above 100. So this is a check constraint. So I'm going to create this. And another is I take here one field, opacity. It is of character 10. And I set default Jalandhar. So by default, Jalandhar will be automatically inserted in the field. Okay, if we are not providing the value, it will take Jalandhar. So all these constraints I am going to create in a going to apply in a table. Look at here. So I am going to drop table student, table deleted, permanently deleted. Now create table student roll number integer primary key, then name character 10, not null, comma marks float, then PAN card character 10. So here unique, then city character 10, default then comma, then check marks less than equal to 100, bracket close, semicolon. So there is a error. I'm checking the error. Error is with the marks. I think it should be in bracket. I'm just okay, students, table created. So any doubt in this? Yes, Ishpaneet, any doubt in this?
No, sir.
Okay, students, now time is over.